And we have an excerpt now on that about the decision with Beltran and a question asked by Evan Roberts of WFAN.
Everybody talked about the Astros cheating. Like, it was out there that there was some rumblings that they were doing something in 2017. When you're sitting there for 8 hours with Carlos Beltran, how does that not come up just out of curiosity when you're interviewing him for such an important position like being the manager of the Mets?
It's important to remember the timeline, and that's why I led with that today, is that when we were going through our interview process in October, there weren't rumblings, or certainly we hadn't heard rumblings and were not aware of any rumblings about what was happening, you know, with any particular team. You know, I started on the job in November of 2018, and at the general manager meetings, you know, this was a topic, the importance of modifying the rules for you know, technology was something that was talked about, and the commissioner made it clear that that using technology for in-game sign stealing was not to be tolerated. You know, what happened or what rumblings, I certainly had no factual basis for anything until this process played itself out.
Well, Carlos Beltran had this to say to Marley Rivera of ESPN today. Over my 20 years in the game, I've always taken pride in being a leader and doing things the right way. And in this situation, I failed. As a veteran player on the team, I should have recognized the severity of the issue and truly regret the actions that were taken. I am a man of faith and integrity, and what took place did not demonstrate those characteristics that are so very important to me and my family. I'm very sorry. It's not who I am as a father, a husband, a teammate, and as an educator. The Mets organization and I mutually agreed to part ways, moving forward for the greater good with no further distractions. I hope that at some point in time, I'll have the opportunity to return to this game that I love so much. All right, so let's go back to the timeline. When he was interviewed for the job, does a question come up? Okay, you buy that maybe it didn't come up at that time. But then right in the wake of this, in the commissioner's statement Monday, Jack, wouldn't it have made sense for somebody to circle back and say, how were you involved? What happened? And then what decision do we make and how do we go the right way?
It's mind-boggling that it wasn't asked, Bob. And I would say in either circumstance, when you are interviewing somebody for that position, and I'm saying when you were interviewing him, this was one of his skills. One of the things that he did well was stealing signs as a player. So I would think that would come up in conversation as the Mets were interviewing him, because it's a complimentary thing. We want to know how to make our players better. Then once the news breaks with the Athletic story, you absolutely have to ask one of your employees, what was your role in this? I listened to that conference call, and Brody Van Wagenen and the GM kept saying, well, we were deferring to MLB. He's your employee. You are paying him to run your franchise. He's a first-year manager. You absolutely have to ask that question. I'm shocked that it never was asked.
Yeah, and for me, it's when the story came out in The Athletic, right? Ken Rosenthal broke that story, that at that point, if you're the GM of the New York Mets, you have to go to your manager and say, I need to know what happened here, because we're going to try to get out ahead of this. You don't let it go for weeks and then react here this week. And I guess you can even say not react this week, right? It was 3 days where they did not make any sort of a comment. They had an embarrassing morning with the Mike Piazza way down in Port St. Lucie. It just was a situation that was not handled the right way. But the fact that you don't go to Carlos Beltran and say, I need to know what happened here, so I have all of the information as a general manager of this team, I need to know what happened.
Can't rewind the hands of time, but let's just say that Beltran statement, Jack, came out on Monday or Tuesday. What's the worst case scenario that could have happened for the Mets?
I think it's a distraction, and we can all guess on how long that distraction lasts. But I absolutely think that we're talking about a different situation here now. That was a very contrite statement, and I'll go you one further, Bob. Forget the statement. Get in front of a microphone. Get in front of a video camera. And say it with contrition, say it apologetically, and I think everything could have changed in this spot. But the longer the Mets delayed, the more I thought Beltran was gone. When this first happened, I thought he might skate on this. He was mentioned in the report, and Manfred, by the way, put him in there for a reason. No other player was mentioned. I thought there was a chance that he would survive. The longer it lasted, I thought the Mets were almost setting him up to fail.
Yeah, I think that they could have gotten ahead of this story. But then the question becomes, could he lead a group of 26 players and staff in that clubhouse when you get to spring training and then get to the regular season? And I think he could have. I think he could have been very honest, like he was with the statement today. And I think he could have done the same thing with his players that first meeting in spring training and say, listen, this is what happened. I made some mistakes. We're not going to let that happen here. I can help you guys out on the field become better baseball players, better major leaguers, and I can teach you how to win the right way. So I think there was still a chance for him to manage this team, and I think be a successful major league manager.